Hello, my name's Anthony Hall. This is a basic tutorial on how to create a basic sword using vectors and then placing it in Lightwave. For this exercise, I've just collected this sword that I've just literally got off of Google, and what I'm going to do is separate the different elements, so the end of the sword, the handle, and the blade, into separate layers so I can make a selection of them, and I'm going to take that selection into Illustrator to convert into vectors. So I'm going to start by separating these elements up. I'm simply just going to cut and paste them onto their own layers. In fact, I'll use so I'm just slowly making selections, cutting and paste them onto their own layer, and then moving them out of the way. Repeat it. I mean, I'm doing it quite quickly, so you might want to take your time, make a better selections than I'm doing, because I am literally speeding through this bit again, and then we've got the sword. So I'm happy with that. I'm gonna select the four layers, and then at the top corner here, go down and I'm gonna merge the layers, and then I'm gonna hold down control on my keyboard and click in the layer to make a selection, create a new layer. And then I'm just going to go edit, fill it with black, like so. Deselect. So I've got the basic shapes. So now what I'm going to do is go File, save it as Sword 1 as a PNG, and just saving it to the desktop. Just replace my last one. Suck that into the dock. Bring up Illustrator. So I've just created a normal A4 portrait document. I'm going to go File, Place, choose the Sword 1 document. Then, when the little icon appears, draw out the actual shapes. Once you've drew it out, at the top you'll notice there's an option that says Image Tray. So click that. And then click expand, and that's converted your document to a vector. If I pull it off the actual white area of the document, you can see it does add a white border to it. So if you switch to the white direct selection tool and then click on the white area and backspace or delete, it will actually delete the white area. Back to the selection tool, move it back onto the document. And then we're just going to export that out. So File, save as from the drop down an editable EPS, save it to the desktop. We'll call it S1 for Sword 1. Save it. What it does, it asks you what the options for the EPS. The only thing you need to change really is I change the version from the current version to version 8, just because I know it always works. Sometimes when you use the newest version, it don't work, but with the version 8, it always seems to work. So press OK. Again, suck that into the dock, and then you can open Lightwave Modeler. To import the vector, we go File, Import EPS. Now for this, what I'm going to do is, usually it'll come out as standard, but I'm going to click Fine, so it'll add a few more points to it. Make sure it's a closed polygon. Auto access drill, so if there's any holes, it will get rid of them, and auto center. And we can leave the scale the same, because that means it's going to bring it through the same size as Illustrator. Choose it from the desktop, so looking for S1. There we go. And then just press OK. So what I've got now is the different shapes that made up the sword that I can start manipulating, and then extruding and making the sword up. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start on the actual sword itself. So what I'm going to do is select it, go to the multiply tab and extrude, and then I'm just going to extrude it, bring up the numerical. Let's have a look. So I'm extruding it. I don't want it to be massively thick, but what I am doing, so this one's about 80 mil, and what I've got is two sides added to it. So basically there's a polygon going down the middle, because I actually want to make each one of the edges come in and be a bit thinner as it goes up to the top of the sword. So for the time being, I'm going to stick with that and then drop the selection. Next, what I'd like to do is I want to switch to the points here over on the left hand side. I'm going to select the middle point, and also I'm going to select the end point of the sword, like so, as you can see. And then I'm going to do the same on the opposite side, because I want to make an edge go all the way down the middle of the sword to help shape the sword itself, like so. And I'm going to go to detail and click border slice, and what that'll do is, based on the actual points you've selected, it'll actually put a slice right through that selection and drop it. Next, what I'm going to do is I want to make the tip of the sword go thinner as it goes from the top downwards. So if I using the actual points tool, if I hold control if you're on a Mac, or if not, right mouse click on a PC, lasso and draw around the actual polygons. So currently they don't line up. So I've got a couple here, look, and I've got one kind of there, but ideally I could do one on this side and then one of these on that side as well, just so when we actually drag it in, they actually all drag in at the same time. So the easiest way to do it, there's numerous ways to do it, but I think what we're going to do is, maybe it's the laziest way to do it, is go to multiply. I'm going to switch and select both sides of the blade, like so. Okay. And then I'm going to use the knife tool, and roughly where the actual point is, draw the actual knife across, and again down here I'm going to do it. So we've actually added some points in that area as such. Then I'm going to go back, like I was going to do originally, making sure the points are selected. I'm going to lasso, or holding down the right mouse click, or if you're on a Mac, it's control, like I said, and select the actual polygons, the points. Zoom in a bit, go to modify size, and I'm going to bring in the actual edges in the right window, that is, in the right window. So you can see as it's going down, it's getting thinner towards the end. What I might do is zoom out a bit, deselect these ones, let's zoom right in, and again stretch these in. What you've got to make sure is that, you know, in the top view here, look, when you're actually stretching, it's got a hat bit of dragging it to the side, so you need to make sure that the actual points are pulled back to the middle. So what I've got is kind of the sword going thinner as it goes to the edge. You can actually do it the opposite way as well and bring these edges in and make it thinner as well, but I'm not going to go and do that. So for the time being, I'm just going to leave my sword blade like that. What I will do, however, is just switch to edges. If you select the edges that make up the front of the blade and the back of the blade, like so. You can also use the stretch tool and just stretch them out slightly, so you're actually bringing the blades out. My suggestion is, because I've just noticed, is when you're doing that, if you hold control, it will, and then pull it out, it will stop it from making these spikes and pulling it out in one other way. So you've kind of got this shape now down the middle of the sword. Okay, so I'm going to leave my blade like that for the time being. Next, I'm going to extrude the top of the handle bit. And so again, I select it, multiply tool, extrude, zoom down, and what I'm going to do is extrude it. Now, when I'm extruding this, I'm looking at the actual blade as well and thinking how thick does it need to be compared to the blade, because I don't want it to be too thick. So again, you can decide how thick you want it to be yourself, but if I bring up the numerical, it's 175. I'm also leaving the extra bit in, so I'm going to stick with 175. I'm then going to select just one polygon at the top of the blade, and then I'm going to go to selections and click connected, so it selects everything to do with it, and then just move it into place. Now, when I'm doing this, obviously you need to keep an eye on the blade, making sure it's centered. I'm just going to pull it so it overlaps the blade slightly. Again, I can go back and I can change this, the position, later. I'm just roughly putting it in where I want it. I'm going to spacebar and then drop the selection, forward slash. So I'm going to stick with that for the time being, and then I'm going to jump on and do the handle. So for the handle, what I'm going to do is first of all find it in my side view, and I'm not actually going to use it. I'm not going to I could extrude it and try and bevel it and place it, but I'm not going to. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the actual points. So if I just switch to points, I'm going to use the points of the actual blade. So if you can see down this one side, I've just selected those points. I'm then going to go edit, copy. I'm going to go on to a new layer and then go edit, paste. So I've actually pasted the actual points. I'm then going to lasso around them by right mouse clicking on my PC mouse, and then go to create, make, and then make curve. So I've actually got the actual side view, the silhouette view of the actual handle. Because what I'm going to do is place this in the center of the grid and use a tool called the lathe tool to lathe round that shape. So next I'm going to go to modify and center all, sorry, then press A on my keyboard. A on your keyboard at any time will center all your windows. So here is the actual shape of that one side. I'm going to move it out slightly, let's say to about here. So I'm actually, here's my main middle of my actual grid, and that's what it's going to lave around. What I am going to do is go to the drag tool, so under modify drag, I'm going to zoom in slightly. I'm just going to grab this point and I'm going to pull it in till it's touching the larger black line. I'm going to go to the bottom and I'm going to drag in exactly the same with this one, like so. So I've got this shape now, as you can see. Next, what I'm going to do is go to multiply, lathe, and then press the numerical. Now, usually when you do the numerical, it will default to 24 sides. So for this one, I'm going to put it down to something like 8. Make sure it's on 360, so it's laving everything around 360 degrees. Now, as you can see inside it, it's just because the actual polygons are flipped the wrong way. To stop it doing that, you literally shut down the lathe tool, drop the tool and press F on your keyboard, and then it flips them round the actual right way. I'd say that the handle is, looks, even though it's the same size as the original, it's a bit small, so we can change that as well. I'm going to click the bottom half of the layer one so I can see my where my sword is, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it with the move tool to where it roughly should be, like so. Now, like I said, I think it's actually a bit small, so what I am going to do is I'm going to go to my points, I'm going to lasso maybe this, the top couple of rows, move to my move tool, hold control down and then pull it up slightly, like so. So I'm actually making it a bit longer. Now, as you can see on the sword, it's a lot bigger around the edge, which I don't quite like. So there's a few things you can do. You can actually, while the whole thing's selected, you can stretch it in, make it a bit smaller if you wish. I mean, it's up, when you get to this kind of stage, you're going to know individually how you want your sword to be, so it's a matter of just deciding how you want it to be and where you want the handles and stuff to go. So what I'm going to do is, like I said, it's pushed inside the blade slightly, so I'm going to stick with that for the time being. So I've just used the stretch tool there. What I am going to do is I'm going to go onto the handle layer, and I'm just going to cut it and paste it onto layer one, like so. So what I've got now is the handle at the top of the sword. Now I'm going to select the other one with the actual polygons and just delete it because I don't need it. And then the last thing I've got is the end bit. So for the actual end bit, you could, if you want, just use the ball tool and squash the ball tool down and make it like an oval shape. But what I'm going to do is just show you how you can use this. So I'm just going to use it exactly the same as what I was doing with the other tools. I'm just going to place it where I want it to be, and then I'm just going to go to multiply, extrude it so much, looking at this size. So I'm going to leave it like that's about that, which is 70 mil. I'm going to drop the selection, I'm going to zoom in, and I'm going to select both sides of the end, and then I'm going to use the bevel tool. So like I've mentioned before, with the bevel tool you can actually pull out and then pull in, like so. So it gives it a nice little bevel. Again, if you right mouse click or you hold control on a PC, you can pull and bevel again, so it gives you another bevel. Making sure that if that happens, that means the corners are overlapping, and so it's making it there's not, you basically, the only way to do it is come really close in here and unwrap the actual bits that are overlapping. So just got to be careful with that. So I've extruded it, I'm going to leave it like that. And then the last thing I'm going to do is select the whole thing by selecting one polygon, go to selections, connect, and I'm just going to check if where it is on here, and if it needs on the top, if it needs pulling in more, if it needs straightening up more, like so. Again, this is something that you might want to decide yourself when you're creating your sword. Spacebar and drop the selection. So what I'm left with is the actual sword made in 3D, just from a vector that I found, like I said, making a selection in Photoshop and then bringing it into Illustrator, tracing it, and then bringing it back through to Lightwave and using some of the tools to make this basic sword. So hopefully you'll learn something, and like most things, it's practice. I did this with two or three other swords. In fact, I've got a final render of a sword that I'll post at the end of this video. So hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.